We have tried in the last 20 years to enact any form of change through educating the public.
Destroy your enemies with as much fury and wrath as you can. And just to plant some seeds in the children's minds here, just firebomb McDonald's. Just firebomb McDonald's.
But we find ourselves at the mercy of a multi-billion pound propaganda machine driven by the BBC and Sky News and other mainstream outlets.
There are suggestions from the group that the police did not handle the collapse of this gentleman effectively, that they were tardy in moving him out of the area. The police view is that they sent in police medics at the time. The police medics came under fire from missiles and items being thrown by protesters and had to take the gentleman out of the cordon. But I am joined by somebody who was there. So can you tell me what you saw?
Yeah, I think in any confrontation, truth is the first casualty. And I just want to clarify the reports I saw from this morning. He was not in his mid-30s. He was a gentleman who seemed to be over 50. He was riddled with tattoos, and from the smell of them, he'd been drinking all day, and his eyes were very wide, as if he was under the influence of drugs.
What about the action of the police?
We can't
speculate about the condition of the gentleman, but
yeah.
What is at issue here is the way the police handled it.
I think I came along at 6:30 last night, and the police seemed to be acting very professionally. There was no overkill, no beatings, and the only reason this gentleman collapsed is because the police ran forward maybe 20 meters at a time, and then he ran off as well, and I saw him collapse and smash his head, and then he was lying there with his eyes wide open, and then a guy in the audience had a megaphone and shouted, "Police, we need a medic," and within seconds the police had a team of 8 people ran forward, and yeah, there was a couple of people throwing bottles and bricks, but there were a few other anarchists who say, "No, stop this, time out." So within seconds, there were no more missiles. So the police were with them for a good, 2 or 3 minutes before they dragged them back. But as they were dragging them back, then the missiles began again.
Just to clarify, were you taking part in the protest? What were you doing then?
I'm a city worker. I was there out of interest and curiosity. Yeah.
Okay, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
That's what I was going to say.
Attempting to get home from work. Walking away from him, he had his hands in his pockets. Here the riot officer appears to strike Tomlinson's leg area with a baton. He then lunges at Tomlinson from behind. Tomlinson is propelled forward and hits the floor.
Driven by the BBC and Sky News and other mainstream outlets, which use incredible technological and psychological tactics to manipulate and keep public opinion on their side.
I saw the tower start to go like that,
right.
but then let's imagine that's there, and then it kind of carried on straight down into the building instead of just going.
When the building begins to fall, it never ever tips over.
Getting them to use flour and stones. Prove to them how a plane can disappear completely. Next, with eggs, he shows them how something can shatter into tiny pieces.
Now you see that the debris has spread out.
And with water bombs, how debris can scatter over a wide area.
Sorry, those not pseudoscience. It was basically, we had the water bombs and the eggs.
It's not pseudoscience. The physics and the kind of thermofluid dynamics of an egg.
Competence, and I'm going to be executed for changing my mind. And the conspiracy has expanded to include me as a mind control victim. And it just shows this kind of levels of dogma, faith, paranoia, and hatred. Now the hatred is projected towards me because I guess I'm making people question their reality. And you know, it's so funny, it's called the 9/11 Truth Movement. Why are people holding on to dogma if I'm trying to go towards the truth? I feel I was given this incredible opportunity to go find out the truth, and I've had to update my opinions about it. And I'm not an engineer and architect, but I hit what they call the wall of absurdity when I realized it couldn't have been an inside job. And I'm here with my model United Airlines 757. I'm going to reclaim 9/11 for the Islamists.
There were no terrorists on September the 11th. It was them and the Israelis. They lied to you. They're using the media, the corporate-controlled media, to tell you lies, to keep you stupid and ignorant. It's all propaganda. It's all rubbish. But the whole theater, you start believing it. Big government, big corporations working together, killing terrorists, keeping you scared. It's not real. None of it is real. It's It's all an illusion. They justify their existence by keeping you terrified, and then you pay taxes. There's no need to. It's all an illusion. Terrorists. No. It was the Israelis and the British and Americans. Did you get your information from the corporate-controlled media, or did you do your own research, sir? You watch the news. It's very true. Keep